Hello everyone! In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to make this smudge painting effect in Photoshop. After following this tutorial, you will create your own smudge painting effect PSD file, and you can reuse that file to reapply the same effect on any new image with a single click. Please like the video and let's get started. Step 1. Create the effect. Let's start by creating a new document. Set width to 3000 pixels and height to 2500 pixels with 300 resolution and RGB color mode. Then click Create. Now go to File, Place Embedded to import your image. Resize your image to fill the canvas, then press Enter. Now press Ctrl and A to select the whole image. And with your layer selected, make a mask out of your selection from here. Right-click your layer and choose Convert to Smart Object. Name it Before and delete the background layer with the Delete key. If you press Ctrl and T, you'll see that we remove the areas outside the canvas like that. And this will make the Smart Object have the same dimension as the document itself. Now select your layer, then press Ctrl and J to duplicate it. Name the layer as you want. And with your layer selected, go to Filter, Sharpen, and choose Unsharp Mask. Change amount to 150, radius to 3, and threshold to 0. Then click OK. This will sharpen your image a little bit. Now let's apply the Oil Paint filter. Change it to 5, 3, 0.1, and 0. And uncheck Lighting. Then click OK. Applying the oil paint filter on a sharp image usually gives a better result. Now go to Filter, Noise, and apply the Reduce Noise filter. Set Strength to 10 and keep all other values 0. Then click OK. This will wipe the details that result from the oil paint filter and make the skin smoother. Let's apply the Surface Blur filter. Change Radius to 15. And threshold to 7. As you can see, both reduce noise and surface blur filters will make the skin look like as if it is digitally painted. Now let's apply the unsharp mask filter again. But this time, change amount to 40 and radius to 15 with 0 threshold. This will increase the contrast of your overall image details like that. Click OK, and let's apply the oil paint filter again. Keep values as before, then click OK. Also, let's reapply the Reduce Noise filter. Leave values as they are, and click OK. Finally, let's apply the Smart Sharpen filter to sharpen the final image details. Change amount to 100, with 3 pixel radius and 0 noise reduction, then click OK. And this is the final result. Before moving to the next step, let's talk about our today's sponsor. Skillshare is a huge online learning platform with thousands of premium classes for all creative and curious people. They have thousands of inspiring classes about graphic design, photography, illustration, filmmaking, freelancing, and much more. They offer almost 3,000 classes about Photoshop only. One class that I really like is the Photoshop Advanced Training course from Daniel Scott. He has almost 14 hours of premium content for this class only. Unlike YouTube, Skillshare is 100% free of ads, so you can stay focused and follow wherever your creativity takes you. And for the first 1,000 people who join Skillshare from the link in my description, we'll get a 1-month free trial of Skillshare Premium membership. Join Skillshare to boost your creativity today. Now let's get back to our tutorial. Step 2. Add glow and tones. First, select the before layer, then press Ctrl and J to duplicate it. Drag that duplicated layer to the top like that. And with your layer selected, go and apply the Gaussian blur filter from here. Change radius to 5 pixels, then click OK. With your layer selected, create an invert layer. Click on this icon to clip mask it to the layer only. Also, create a hue and saturation layer and clip mask it. Reduce the saturation all the way down to minus 100. And finally, select your layer and change its blending mode to overlay. This will fake a HDR tone to your final effect like that. And you can control it by changing the layer opacity like that. Name it HDR tone. Then hold the Alt key and click and drag the layer to the top to duplicate it like that. Name that duplicated layer Smudge Tone. Then change its blending mode to Multiply. You can also control that tone using the opacity slider like that. Finally, let's select the main effect layer and duplicate it with Ctrl and J. Name that duplicated layer Glow. And with your layer selected, go and open the Filter Gallery filter. Under the Distort folder, choose the Diffuse Glow filter. Change it to 0, 3, and 18. This will increase the glow in the brightest areas in your image. Click OK and let's move on. Collapse that layer and let's control it by changing the opacity like that. You can select the glow layer, then hold the Shift key and select the top layer to select all three layers. Press Ctrl and G to group them and name that group Change Opacity. These are the effect controllers. You can control your effect by changing the opacity of each layer of them. Now let's move on to the final step. Step 3, adjustments and updating the effect with a single click. Let's start by selecting our top layer. Then create a vibrance layer with plus 20 vibrance and plus 5 saturation. Also, create a levels layer. Change it to 10, 1.05 and 240. And finally, create a color balance layer. Start adjusting each tone slightly like that. Now let's see the final result. That's great. Now let's apply the same effect on any new image with a single click. Just double click on any smart object thumbnail to open it. Hide the layer inside it, then go and import any new image. Now press Ctrl and S to update the smart objects. Get back to your main document and start changing the opacities of each layer until you have a good result. And this is the final result. You can save this project as a PSD file for any future use. That's it for today. Please like the video and subscribe for more free tutorials. Thanks for watching.